Hi, my name is Lisa, owner of Rocky Mountain Mind Body Therapy. Welcome to our Friday morning chair class. So let's go ahead and get started and scoot all the way back in your chair. And close your eyes. And find a comfortable seat. And just draw your attention to your breath. Just mentally putting aside your to-do list for the next 50 minutes while we focus on taking care of our bodies. Temple of the Holy Spirit within. So if y'all can't hear me in the back row, speak up, let me know. So as we're focusing on our breath, let's deepen our breath, filling up our belly, our chest, feeling the rise and fall. Inhaling fully and exhaling fully. That life force energy that God breathed into us long ago, breathed into Adam. As we continue to breathe deeply, today's devotional comes from Our Daily Bread, entitled Mistakes Made Beautiful. And the scripture reading comes from Luke 22:49-51, when Jesus was about to be arrested. When the other disciples saw what was about to happen, they exclaimed, "Lord, should we fight? We brought swords." And one of them struck the high priest's slave, slashing off his right ear. But Jesus said, "No more of this." And he touched the man's ear and healed him. So, a story by Julie Ackerman. Early in his career, jazz player Herbie Hancock was invited to play in the quintet of Miles Davis, who was already a musical legend. In an interview, Hancock admitted being nervous, but described it as a wonderful experience because Davis was so nurturing. During one performance, when Davis was near the high point of his solo, Hancock played the wrong chord. He was mortified, but Davis continued as if nothing had happened. "He played some notes that made my chord right," Hancock said. What an example of loving leadership. Davis didn't scold Hancock or make him look foolish. He didn't blame him for ruining the performance. He simply adjusted his plan and turned a potentially disastrous mistake into something beautiful. Anybody like to open in prayer? Thanks.
Heavenly Father, we thank you for today. We thank you for this opportunity to come and be a part of this exercise class. We pray you'd be with Lisa as she leaves us. Help us all to seek to do your will every day that we live. It's our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Okay, let's go ahead and scoot up in our chairs. Coming into seated spinal circles, inhaling forward and exhale, rounding the back. Being sure to have your feet out in front of you, firmly planted. Moving the spine in all different directions. So good for the spine. Like they say, motion is lotion. Pause, reverse direction. Inhaling forward and exhale, rounding the back. Make your circles smaller and smaller. And coming back to stillness. And then we'll move into our cat-cow. So inhale, looking slightly up, arching your back slightly. And then exhale, rounding the back into cat. So looking at it from the side, inhale into cow. And exhale, cat. So, and a reminder, if you have osteopenia or osteoporosis, you only want to go 50 or 70%. You don't want to overly flex the spine or overly extend the spine. Coming back to stillness, sitting up tall, inhale the shoulders up and back, and let them settle down. And continuing in shoulder circles, inhaling up, exhaling down. Take the feet out wide, a little wider than hip width. Scoot up toward the edge of the chair. And the fingertips come to the insides. And inhale tall. And exhale, dipping the right shoulder. And inhale tall. Exhale, dipping the left. And continuing with the breath. Inhaling up, exhaling down. Evened out on both sides, go ahead and maybe scoot back a little bit, and then take the feet out and the hands up and circling the wrists and the ankles. Hearing a lot of pops in the room, including my own. Good getting all the pops out. And then reverse direction. And then shaking that out, we're going to maybe scoot up just a little bit. And take the right foot up and left hand up and down. And then inhale the other left leg, the right hand up, exhale down. And just following the breath, alternating side to side. To add, inhale up, exhale, drawing elbow towards the knee, inhale up, and exhale down. Inhale up, exhale, elbow towards knee, inhale up, and exhale down. So just continuing with the breath. So I was telling everybody I forgot my laptop. So on the chair yoga dance, we're on our own to try to remember how it goes. Sherry Zach Morris has a lot of great chair yoga videos out there that I like to follow. When you're evened out on both sides, go ahead and grab your strap. Let's see, rolling it out. And you'll want to have the buckle, just let the buckle fall to the ground. And then we're going to take the strap, I don't know, about, what is that, about 2 feet? 2.5 feet? Or maybe 3 feet? And we're just going to lasso, twirl the strap around like we're lassoing a cow. Somebody was making fun of me, being from Texas, so, you know, that's what inspired this. You can blame them. I think it was Bruce.
Sounds about right.
Right. And then reverse direction. Oops. And you can take it out to the side. Maybe the other side. And then go ahead and switch hands. So, the shorter the strap, the less challenging. Well, maybe. And the longer the strap. Just make sure the buckle is not in the air. Oh, I just hit myself in the nose. I did it again.
I'm glad that was you.
Thanks.
No, I did that before.
And then reverse direction. Let's see. That's kind of hard on the left hand. And my left. You're right. It's funny how you can reverse things and, you know, it makes your mind work, you know. And then maybe taking it out to the side. Maybe the other side. All right. So let's shake that out. And we'll take the strap, this time the buckle in your hand, and taking it as wide as you like, about 3 feet. And then inhale up and exhale down. And inhale up. And exhale down. And then this time inhaling up and exhale behind the back, maybe going wider on the strap. And inhale up and exhale down. So just following the breath, a few more of these. Wake the shoulders up on a Friday morning. So one more time, inhaling up and exhaling back. And then go ahead and put the strap to the side. And we're ready for blast offs. Are y'all ready? So how many do we want to do? 5, 7, or 10? How adventurous are y'all? We'll go 7. So, let's see, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and blast off. All right, so let's go ahead and come to the back of the chair. So I'm moving mine up because I don't have room back here, but it'd probably be a good thing for you to move yours up too. So we're going to grab the back of a chair and walk both feet back, coming into down dog, revised down dog with the chair. So hinging at the hips and keeping the back flat as you bend over, keeping the arms fairly straight. You can have a slight bend in the elbows. So just hinging at the hip, not leaning on the chair. Stretching out that the upper back feels so good. Maybe walking the feet a little bit, so lifting up the right heel, and then lift up the left. And then step forward with the right foot. So we're in kind of a lunge position, and we might as well just do lunge push-ups. So exhale down. And inhale up. Did you hear my elbows pop? We'll get the strengthening exercises out of the way. So hugging the elbows in close to the body as you exhale down and inhale up. Coming back up, we're going to shift the grip, so maybe gripping so the fingers are more in, and maybe moving on the outside of the chair. So this time we're going to take the elbows out, coming into bicep push-ups. Exhale down, and inhale up. Works another set of muscles here. And then go ahead and let's see, step back and coming in to leaning, hinging at the hip, keeping the back flat, coming into pyramid pose. Stretching out that right hamstring. Coming back to our breath, remembering our breath. like we did at the first of the class, breathing deeply, inhaling fully, exhaling fully. So bend the right knee, the front knee, and stack that right knee over the right ankle. And when you do that, the back heel will probably pop up. So coming into our lunge, and then playing with the balance. Maybe taking one hand up, maybe both hands. And then bringing the one hand down on the back of the chair. And if you want, you can inhale up and exhale, bending the knees just slightly, just enough to engage those quads. Good. And then go ahead, bring the other hand back and step up. Woo, and shake the legs out. So stepping back on the right foot, left foot's in front, and we'll do a few more lunge push-ups. So exhale. So this time we're going to hug the elbows in to the towards the body, and exhale down, and inhale up. So your grip, your hands are more outward than on bicep push-ups. This helps work your triceps. Which helps to get rid of the, you know, if you have any flabbiness underneath your arms. And go ahead and shift your grip. So taking your hands more on the outside of the top of the chair and fingers facing in, so the elbows come out this time. Inhaling up and exhaling down. Building those strong arms. Step back on that right foot, straighten out the left leg, hinge at the hip, keeping the back flat as you lean over for pyramid pose on the other side. Breathing into that nice hamstring stretch on the left leg. So bending that front knee, coming into a lunge. So making sure the left knee is stacked above the left ankle. You want to be able to look down and see your toes. And you can play with your balance, maybe taking one hand up, maybe both. And if you want more exercise, you can exhale, bending the knee slightly. Inhale up and exhale down, inhale up. Again, it doesn't take much bending in this, much lowering to engage those quads and that back calf muscle. And then go ahead, bring arms down. And seems like I'm forgetting something. Anybody, did I forget something? Seemed like there was something else on this side. Okay. We'll go ahead and step up, shake it out. And coming over to the right side of our chair. Working on our balancing pose. So we're going to spread the toes on the left foot, the right foot. And then sending the right hand out, engage the core. And then picking up the left foot. And coming into our figure eights. So pretending like you have a crayon and or a marker in between your toes and drawing a figure eight on the floor. So finding something still to focus on. And reverse direction. And then go ahead and step down on that left foot. And this time we're going to step back a little behind the chair and place your right foot down, so spread the right toes wide, and then the left foot in front of it. And then just play with your balance, finding something still to focus on. And if you want more of a challenge, you can close your eyes and try it. As you can see, I'm a little off balance in this. Pretending like we're on a balance beam. And then go ahead and place the hand on the chair as we shift the right foot in front of the left. And engage the core. And then play with your balance. Like we did when we were kids, we were always playing with our balance. And then go ahead, place the hand on the back of the chair and shake that out. Coming over to the other side, move on a step. So go ahead in this transition and grab a drink of water. Is that music too loud over there? All right, so left side of the chair. So rooting down and to the left foot, spreading the toes wide, sending the left arm out, engage the core, and then lift up the right leg, and coming in to figure eights, finding a focal point, making sure not to stick out the hip out to the side like I was doing. So you might find you're more coordinated on one side than the other. So it's good to work both sides in yoga and dancing. Even just standing, brushing your teeth. Maybe brushing your teeth with your left hand for a change. Helps work the brain. And then reverse direction. So go ahead and step down on that right foot, shake it out. So this time placing the left foot behind, so step a little behind the chair. And then the right foot comes in front. And then, you know, the hand can be resting on the back or maybe just playing around with it. Finding a focal point, spot on the floor. Something still, engaging the core for better balance. Continuing to breathe. Sometimes we hold our breath in balance poses. And then go ahead and rest your hand on the chair as we transition and step the left foot in front. So spreading the toes wide, engaging the core, finding that still focal point to focus on, and playing with the balance. And again, if you want more of a challenge, you can close your eyes. Make sure the chair is nearby. Okay, so go ahead, we'll step out of that. And let's see, one more thing. We're going to come to the side of the chair, so the right side of the chair. And then place the, so hinge at the hips, and then keeping the back flat, placing the hands on the chair. And we're gonna shift the weight into the left foot and lifting the right leg, coming into the modified warrior three. So you want the standing leg to have a slight bend in it. And then maybe pulsing that right leg up and down just a little bit. And then go ahead and shift legs so the right foot comes down. And then shift your weight to the right foot. Spread the right toes wide, slight bend in the right knee as you lift that left leg up. And then you can flex that left foot as you pulse up and down. Go ahead, place the left foot on the floor, walk up to the chair, and then stand up. And we're going to scoop the chairs back, halfway back on the mat, and come to a seat. Maybe grab a drink of water while I switch the music to our chair dance. Compliments of Sherry Zach Morris. Thank you, Sherry.